Mirza Haider. When the evil armor took over Samarkand, Mirza Haider had to flee. Only 40 of his closest officers rode with him. They rode hard, trying to reach the safety of Hindustan. Otherwise, the armor would surely try to kill them. Soon, they were among the steep and treacherous mountain passes of the Himalayas. High up, water froze to ice, leaving nothing to drink. Food grew scarce. The horsemen had never seen many of the local plants before, and some ate poisonous leaves. Others could hardly breathe, for they were high up in the mountains, where the air was thin. Without water, food and air, how could they survive? One by one, many of his officers died, followed by the horses. Yet, Mirza Haider did not give up. Out of 40 officers, only 15 were left when he finally crossed the mountains into the valley of Kashmir. But the bravery of those who died was never forgotten. The poachers. Terence was a forest ranger. There had been a series of attacks on wild animals in the last few weeks, and the rangers were determined to catch the poachers. Tonight, Terence had tracked a large herd of elephants. They were heading straight for a local watering hole. So Terence hid himself in a tall tree and waited. For a long time, the only sound in the forest was that made by the animals. Then, around midnight, he heard the hoot of an owl. He knew that was a fake bird call. Scanning the undergrowth through his night vision goggles, he soon located two poachers. They had rifles with silencers and were taking aim at the largest tusker. Immediately, Terence took aim as well. With a perfect aim, he shot the tranquilizer darts at the poachers. Within moments, they were both unconscious. Terence and the other rangers moved in swiftly, arresting them and ensuring that the animals were safe. The cruise adventure. Anna was on a cruise ship with about 50 people on board. One night after dinner, Anna was standing on the upper deck, admiring the moonlight. Suddenly, she heard a scuffle and a small splash. Looking over, she clearly saw a figure sinking in the water and another running away from the deck below. Anna ran down and dived into the sea. She barely managed to save an old man, leading him to the captain. Anna told him everything. He said, "Ma'am, let me gather everyone by a storm warning siren." A moment later, the warning siren rang out and all the passengers gathered on the deck. Besides, old Mr. Hubbs, whom Anna had saved and who lay down in the captain's cabin, a wicked man, Nat Daniels, was missing. A moment later, Nat came running to the deck, looking sly and uncomfortable. The captain and his guards fought Nat at once for trying to kill Mr. Hubbs. The Merchant's Adventure. Mir Singh was going to Bukhara from Punjab as a part of a trading caravan. He had heard of the wonderful markets there and was excited to see them himself. The caravan had just entered the passes of Afghanistan. However, when they were attacked by a tribe of Pashtuns, they plundered the goods and sold the merchants to a slave trader. A month later, Mir Singh found himself in the market at Bukhara. However, now he was no longer a merchant. He was being sold as a slave. Since he was young and strong, he was soon sold to a local silk merchant. Mir Singh tried to escape, but each time he was caught and brought back. Finally, one day, his master fell ill. Mir Singh thought, "This is my chance." He sneaked out in the night and after hiding for 3 days, finally found a caravan going to India. He was going home at last.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.